What is the perspective which I am talking about? Indological perspective. Indological perspective. The contextual specificity of Indian society can be captured only through ideology. Through text, you can understand the context. So it was Indological perspective which propagated, which practiced a book view of Indian civilization. Studying of script, language, Vedas, Upanishads, architecture will help you understand the culture and the civilization of Indian society, which is unique in structure as well as function. Indological perspective makes societies getting classified on binary axis. That the society is rigid society or the society is a fluid society. The culture and the structure of the social stratification system is refusing to change, or there is a social stratification system which is adaptive in character, which changes across time and space. The first viewpoint was taken up by G.S. Gowrie. Of course, Orientalists looked at the unique nature of Indian civilization, culture, Indian villages and caste system, but they looked at Indian society from the perspective of ethnocentrism. They compared Indian society to that of their Western society, ultimately judged Indian society and its culture as inferior to that of the Western civilization. And this became the basic pretext of British colonialism of Indian society, that it is the white man's burden to develop the dark continent. G.S. Gowrie is a student of diffusionist school. He was a scholar in Sanskrit language as well as a Saraswat Brahmin. It is found that sociologists who study society, they are heavily influenced by their own culture, their own value system. And this brings the question of how possible is an objective study of Indian society. Being a Saraswat Brahmin, G.S. Gowrie gives more importance to Hinduism and Sanskritic language. According to Gowrie, the unique nature of Indian society lies in the fact that despite of the absence of any centralized rule, language called Sanskrit, religion called Hinduism was integrating India into one single unit. The mosaic of Indian society was held together by language and religion. His approach was also very much indebted to the Asiatic society, started by William Jones. Through book view, G.S. Gowrie tries to capture the unique cultural fabric and civilizational content of Indian society. He made a detailed account of caste system, tribal society, religion, and social tension using Indology. In the study of caste and race in India, G.S. Gure explains caste system as a unique form of social stratification system characterized by the following features. Write all these six features which we have spoken before. He also looks at how tribes are backward Hindus. They are attempting to get assimilated into the mainstream Hindu culture. Since the assimilation is not complete, they remain as backward Hindus. They remain as backward Hindus. He was even suggesting assimilation approach of the tribe rather than national park approach, which led to debate between isolation approach forwarded by Verrier Elvin and assimilation approach of the for the tribal welfare as suggested by G.S. Gure. Gure makes a study of Indian culture and civilization. The civilizational unique and the cultural uniqueness of Indian society can be understood by studying the foundations of culture. He mentions about some important elements in the foundation of culture which makes India unique. It is characterized by, the foundation of culture is characterized by or contained by religious consciousness, conscience, then justice, then freedom of expression and free pursuit of knowledge, and fifth is tolerance. He also looks at Indian society, Indian civilization in terms of gradation of value system. Talcott Parsons spoke about how stratification system is based on hierarchy of groups centering around values. So social stratification system of caste system is based on hierarchical gradation of value system. Thus, those who are at the top of the hierarchy, they practice a value system which is considered superior to the value system practiced by those at the bottom. Mackie Marriott speaks about how those at the top of the hierarchy, they practice great tradition, and those at the bottom of the hierarchy practice little tradition. So caste system is characterized by hierarchy of value system. Class system is characterized by hierarchy of groups based on economic criteria. Scholars comparing stratification system of the West and East find that caste is characterized by values which are very subjective And this subjectivity is what is expressed in the form of the notion of purity and pollution. Whereas class-based society bases people in a hierarchical fashion centering around economic criteria, which happens to be objective. So the limitation of indological perspective is, unlike study of class system, which is based on objective criteria, study of caste system cannot be empirically validated as it contains subjectivity, the criteria being values, and that what resulted in criticism against indological perspective. Feminist scholars criticized Gure's indological perspective as not giving adequate importance to the need for gender equality. Gure subscribes to a subjective viewpoint. He was influenced by his own personal culture. He colored his study using his own perspective, characterized by his support to upper caste value system. Being a Brahmin, he supports hierarchy present in caste system. He supports Hinduism. He supports Sanskrit language. So G.S. Gure is not accommodating to the heterogeneous character of Indian society, looks at Indian society only through the prism of homogeneity. Dalit sociologists like Gail Omwet criticizes Indological perspective as not highlighting the problems of the subaltern. His sociology is not offering solution to the pressing problems of untouchability, violence against Dalits, structure functionalism is also offering its critique to Indological perspective, saying that your book view should be replaced by field view. M.N. Srinivas, though a student of G.S. Gure, looks at the limitations of Indological perspective, that this perspective is not adequately giving importance to empirical research. Hence, there may be a problem of objectivity in Indological sociology. Gure is not able to explain the dynamics present in Indian society, the changing nature of caste, the rise of democracy, and the various political configurations taking place centering around caste in Indian politics. These are not adequately dealt by G.S. Gure. However, M.N. Srinivas appreciates Indology of G.S. Gure, saying that like a beautiful butterfly which switches from one flower to another flower, G.S. Gure is brilliantly switching over various themes present in Indian society, for which he should be regarded as an intellectual giant and a founder of Indian sociology, or a father of Indian sociology. Right? So this should be your answer for G.S. Gure.